Good morning, guys. Today, an exciting video again with a lot of information. Of course, I'm going to talk about Jess's birthday, but I will keep this one till the end. Yes, at the end, I will also add the winner of the prize contest of the t-shirt. So make sure you watch the video till the end so you can see if you are one of the winners of the t-shirt. We, of course, start again with the Bitcoin prize because you love it. We are going to show you which levels to keep an eye on. We're going to show you this diamond shape, which could predict the future of Bitcoin. I'm going to show you 9 billionaires that own a huge portion of Bitcoins. Talk about the Bitcoin block generation, because that dropped to another low. BitMEX is facing this lawsuit, and I do agree with one thing in this lawsuit, which I really don't like. How the Fed made this beautiful case for you all why to invest in Bitcoins just showed the weakness of fiat and the strength of Bitcoin. One of the high-ranked people in the Central Bank of Lebanon that was again fooling the normal people by doing all kinds of illegal stuff. And to end it positive, we will talk about how in Arizona now they use this beautiful DAP to do a voting. That means that we will get a democracy that we deserve as the people. Make sure you watch the video till the end, because there's a lot of cool news in this one. Have fun watching it, guys. Good morning, guys, on this beautiful day again here on Koh Phan Gan, Thailand. Welcome to my office, guys. Yes, it is my normal office in front of my house, because guys, I woke up a little bit late this morning, but I promise you guys, tomorrow I will show you another beautiful location here on Koh Phan Gan, Thailand. I'm going to start off with the price, of course, and then follow up with some beautiful, very exciting other news, the price of Bitcoin. As you would expect, of course, we are still moving in the same range or channel I said to you yesterday. We are bouncing between 10K and 8K and 10K for the last couple of weeks. And I think this will continue a little bit more. Before I went to sleep, I saw one of my friends here on the island, Carl the Moon. He was talking about this diamond shape that was forming now in the charts. Yes, I have seen this diamond shape as well. It is a difficult one to predict the future, because in 57% of the times the diamond shape breaks out downwards, and 43% of the time the diamond shape breaks out upwards. So this is almost a 50-50 gamble. But then again, yeah, it shows that there will be a Bitcoin move in the next 2 days between now and the 20th of May. So if you are thinking of buying Bitcoin, I would wait 1 or 2 days. Why? Because let's say you have $10,000 and you want to buy this Bitcoin. If Bitcoin breaks down, you're lucky. You are maybe able even to buy Bitcoin at 7K or 8K. If Bitcoin breaks up, then you can see Bitcoin breaking up to 10K, 10.5K, 11K. Then you just buy Bitcoin a little bit more expensive. But then again, you're sure that Bitcoin is going up from that moment. So in the short term, yes, you make a little bit less profit, but you play the game a little bit more safe. But in the long term, what does these $500 to $1,000 mean if Bitcoin will go up to 20K or 50K or 100K? Then it's just $500 to $1,000 less profit. So that's why I tell you guys always to zoom out. In the short term, if you want to make money daily, then you need to zoom in. If you just want to play the game with a peace of mind, not to stress too much, then you just zoom out and you just don't take unnecessary risk and you just wait for a confirmation. The confirmation of going down or the confirmation for going up. If it would go up, I think the next resistance will be around 11,000, like 11,500-ish. But that's beautiful, because it's not a very strong resistance, and if we're gonna break that resistance, we will soon see $14,000, I think. The biggest resistance now we are facing is this huge Bitcoin sell wall around $10,200. I think it's more than 6,000 Bitcoins that are being sold around this area. So we need to buy up all these Bitcoins to have Bitcoin even move up. Often in these times when we don't succeed in buying up all these Bitcoins, the price, you know, pulls back a little bit to 8,000 to get new fresh investors in this market. And these new and fresh investors help us push Bitcoin again a little bit higher and maybe then break this beautiful level of 10,500, which is a level we have been fighting for now almost 2 years. So please understand, it's a long-term game when it comes to investing in Bitcoin at the moment. I just watch my videos every day and I try to educate you as much as possible and warn you as much as possible for a drop or a run that is about to happen. And while you're watching this video, maybe I should remind you that there is a thumbs up below the video. You can always hit the thumbs up. This is very positive for the YouTube algorithm, and it gives them a sign, wow, Didi's channel is really cool, I like it very much. And then there is another button. If you subscribe to our channel, they love it even more. And if you hit this beautiful bell button, they go completely crazy and they are like, wow, this is really cool content that people want to see day in, day out. So please hit all those three of them, and then even maybe at the end of the video, if you really like it, share the video with your community, because the monetization will lead to sharing with poor people all over the world, and this is exactly what we want to show you in our videos. Sorry, that was a hiccup from all the rum coke I drank yesterday again on Jesse's beautiful birthday. If you look at the mining business at the moment, if you look at the Bitcoin block generation, there is something really strange happening over there, because we saw a low in generating of new blocks. I think yesterday there were only 95 new blocks mined, which only happened 8 times in the last 10 years. So only 8 times in the last 10 years there were less Bitcoin mined than 95 Bitcoins. Why is this happening? This is very logical. Because of the Bitcoin price, many miners are shutting down their equipment. So the halving already made the creation of Bitcoin drop with 50%. And then if miners at the same time shut down their systems, that will drop with another 20% or something. So, you know, then less Bitcoins are being created. So let's see what happens. I think that when the Bitcoin price will go up a little bit above 10K, more and more miners will start to put the miners on again. Guys, to educate you a little bit more, it doesn't only have to do with the cost of mining, or, you know, with the Bitcoin price, but it also has to do, guys, with the transactions we do. The more transactions happen in Bitcoin, the more the miners will also receive in fees. So that's why it's very important that we start to use Bitcoin as well. Not only HODL, yes, that's a good thing to HODL Bitcoin, but it's also a very good thing to spend your Bitcoins. But because by spending Bitcoins, you create transactions, and by creating transactions, you create the payments of fees. And by the payments of fees, you support the miners again, and these miners again support the security of the whole network. And that's why it's very important that not only the price goes up, but that we also start to use Bitcoin. This is what we have shown as a family the last year a lot of times in our videos. If you are a new follower, look at the old videos where we go into the stores and we ask all these stores, these big stores in Spain and all over Europe, why don't you accept Bitcoin? Maybe you should accept Bitcoin, where we educate all these store holders on how to accept Bitcoin. They are really cool and fun videos, so make sure you watch these old videos as well, where you even see Jessa, who celebrated her 10th birthday yesterday, see her asking this guy in a store, can I pay this bowl with Bitcoins? And then you see his answer. These videos cost us more than like a day or two on creating with all the editing, and these videos are still undervalued in my opinion, because we spend a lot of time to creating that beautiful content as a family, where we spend a lot of time traveling, driving, and all these things. So I think they are undervalued. We need to watch these videos a little bit more as well. Please do so. Thank you from the bottom of my heart if you watch these old videos as well. Sorry, that was me rambling on again. I will take this beautiful walk at to this part of the beach again, because I know you like this part of the beach. It's a very beautiful white sand area with beautiful palm trees. And while doing so, I get this billionaire feeling. I am showing you, you can also enjoy this beautiful billion-dollar view, billion-dollar area without owning billions and just being a happy family traveling the world. But talking about billionaires, guys, yes, we have now many, many billionaires invested into Bitcoin. Why might that be? Why would these billionaires now invest in Bitcoin? Oh, that's a massage. Nice. They have a reason, and it's the same reason you are invested in Bitcoin, because they trust that Bitcoin will be a safe store of value in the next couple of years when we will face this huge crisis that we are started to face now. This is just the beginning, and it will end in a couple of years, and you need to hedge a part of your capital into different store of values, because you need to, maybe you already own a house, this is kind of store of a value. If the housing market won't crash, if you own some gold, this is a kind of store of value. Maybe if you have some money on your banks, that is not a store of value. This is devaluating. You're going to pay a negative interest rate. This means you need to pay interest to hold your money on a bank account. So if you want to diversify, just make sure you include a little bit Bitcoin into your portfolio, so you average out your investment returns in the near future. The billionaires, that is where I got stuck and I got rambling on again. You know, we have Elon Musk, who admitted he has 0.25 Bitcoins. We have Mark Cuban, he said he has $130 worth of Bitcoin by accident, something to do with the NBA being sponsored by Bitcoins or something. So that is how we received $130 worth of Bitcoin. Of course, we have Paul Tudor, which announced like a week ago that 1% of his total capital is hedged into Bitcoin. So he is worth a few billions. So just do the calculation, 1% of those billions are into Bitcoin. Brian Armstrong, of course, from Coinbase, he doesn't want to say how many Bitcoins he has, but he started when Bitcoin was $13, so I think he has a shitload of Bitcoins as well. Jack Dorsey, the CEO of Twitter, he has been telling us many times that he is buying 10K of Bitcoins every week. CZ of Binance, I think he... somewhere in the past he tweeted he owns 1600 or 1700 Bitcoins, which of course is also a very, very big amount of Bitcoins. CZ, if you're watching this, yes, I hold some Bitcoins on Binance as well. I support Binance as well. So if you want to support our beautiful family traveling around this world, just send me 1, 2, maybe 5 of your beautiful stack of 1600 Bitcoins. Mostly smiling works. Just smile all the day and you get things for free. That was a life lesson. Then we, of course, we have the Winklevoss twins, who together claim to own more than 1% of the total amount of Bitcoins around, which is a huge number as well. You do the calculations. Then we have Tim Draper. He owns more than 30,000 Bitcoins. That's also a big number, 30,000 Bitcoins. What would you do with 30,000 Bitcoins? Please comment below. I want to know, if you now had 30,000 Bitcoins, what would the first thing you would do with this amount of Bitcoins? And then last but not least, Shamat, and his last name is very difficult to pronounce, Palihapitiya or something like this. Sorry if I pronounce it wrong, but this guy is saying he owns 5% of the total amount of Bitcoins that is floating around on this beautiful world that you're now seeing as well on the background of this video. If you just look behind my sweaty forehead, because it's bloody hot again. So these billionaires all trust Bitcoin. They all hedge into Bitcoin because they want to be sure that if Bitcoin will be this new digital store of value, replacing this old-fashioned world of golden bricks that we cannot like ship around the world in a very easy way like Bitcoin, then if they trust it, I think you should start to take Bitcoin a little bit more serious day by day. Do we have some more news? Yes. Why? Because BitMEX is in a lawsuit. Why is BitMEX in a lawsuit? Many reasons. It's a whole big file of accusations of money laundering, of many illegal things. But the one thing I think is the most important, and maybe you think different about it, but for me, the most important part in this lawsuit is that they are being accused to have their own profit trading desk that is trading on their own BitMEX platform. So you own a trading platform where you give this beautiful option for all us beautiful people to trade Bitcoins and to try to make some profit. And at the same time, you own a trading desk with professional traders with probably more knowledge and experience than the normal traders. And this desk is trading on the same exchange. So I don't really like this because, you know, who doesn't say that they have all the insights of the numbers, that they have this backdoor access into the exchange where they can read out all the numbers and everything that is happening on the BitMEX exchange. Then it would make it very unfair for the normal people that are trying to make a living out of trading, and they are now competing to a desk that is owned by the same exchange they are trading on. Let's see what will happen in the future with this. But this also tells me again, guys, to warn you, please, please hodl the biggest part of your Bitcoins always on a wallet that you have access to the private keys. It can be a beautiful hardware wallet like a Ledger. I'm using the Bitbox, for example. You can find some beautiful links down below the video to this store where you can buy this beautiful hardware wallet, or you just put some Bitcoins in a software wallet. But then again, a software wallet that gives you access to the private keys. There's a list on our website of these wallets that we trust, so just visit our website. The Fed yesterday made a beautiful case to invest in Bitcoin, so now even normal people need to start investing in Bitcoins. Why? The Fed was in the 60 Minute show and he said, if we need more money, we just print it digital. How do you think that this will evolve in the future? And he said, we will print as much as we need. So this is a huge indicator that Bitcoin is very important, because we cannot print any more Bitcoins than the 21 million Bitcoins. If you just are able to just print money digital now, that's really easy. You know, that can never be positive for the value of the dollar or the euro, because it's just being created out of thin air. This will always lead and end into a huge inflation. And we have seen these inflations, as you have heard in my previous videos, many times before. Also in Europe, also in the States, we have seen it everywhere. This, together with the news that one of the high-ranked employees of the Central Bank of Lebanon was arrested because of fraud. He was manipulating the market of Lebanese money. And this is, of course, illegal. That shows us again that we can't trust these people running the central banks, because they will do everything for their own benefit and not for your benefit. I think it's very good that these guys are now being arrested in Lebanon, and the next couple of years we will probably see some more arrests, because I think it's time that we really look at what the central banks have been doing the last couple of years to our economy, to our money, and to our lives. I'm going to wet my face a little bit, it's really hot. Oh, I'm going to walk in the water because I need to cool off. I don't want to end this episode negative, so I'm going to end it positive. The state of Arizona just did a beautiful test again with using a voting app on the blockchain. It's called Votes. This shows the power of the blockchain and the power of voting with a blockchain app like Votes, because this is probably going to save our democracy in the future. And let's hope many countries will follow and use this beautiful blockchain technology for their voting internally in their countries.
Bitcoin Texas for the t-shirt. This is the contest. I am now going to have Siri decide which number wins the contest, and then I will have this t-shirt created and sent to you guys all for free. Thank you for joining the contest. Let's see if this works.
Siri, give me a random number between 1 and 27.
The answer is 24.
The number 24 won the game. This is the text.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24.
The text, be yourself, will be on a t-shirt. I'm going to search now through all the comments who invented this text, but I will find out, and I will have this t-shirt designed and made and sent to you. Just private message me with your address and everything, and I will make sure everything will be fine. Thanks again for joining the contest, and enjoy the rest of the video.
And we are going to end the video, of course, with a beautiful story about my daughter Jessa, who turned 10 years old yesterday. I think you all seen in the videos that Jessa is the most energetic girl you could ever see. Yes, she wakes up in the morning, she starts talking, and she ends with talking in the evening. Maybe she looks a little bit like me, but that is what I love about Jessa. She's a wild kid. She hasn't gone to school, so she is this raw product of a digital nomad traveling life, and you can really see this in her attitude. We had some friends over, she played on the beach, she had this water fight, we had some dance with the music. She even played this game with her friend in the Netherlands. I don't know how it's called. I think it's called Roadblocks. They are building these cities and houses together everywhere online now. So yes, this is also an indicator for me that the thing I've been talking about the last few weeks, gamification of the world, where people spend time as an avatar in this beautiful virtual world, is really becoming the truth for kids like Jess's age. She wasn't able to celebrate her birthday with some friends in the Netherlands, so what did she do? She invited these friends into this online area where they celebrated her birthday, played some games, and that is how they keep contact with other kids all over the world. And that is how our world is changing from this normal 2D world into this virtual 3D world, where kids are able to meet each other 24/7 everywhere where they want, and they even create their own dream environment in these beautiful virtual worlds. This will grow even more in the future. We had a beautiful cake with Jessa. She wanted a huge cake with her own face on it, so that is what we bought. They need to send these cakes from Bangkok, because in Koh Phangan, this small island, they cannot create a cake with like photo printed covers. All in all, it was a beautiful day. And how did the day end? We were in the sea and we saw this fisherman coming out of his boat, and he had four huge kingfish, like 80 centimeter kingfish. And we just asked the fisherman, could we buy one of you to celebrate this beautiful birthday in the evening, and then prepare this fish for our guest? This fisherman needed to think, because these kingfish is of course his way of trading and his way of making money. So he wanted to check for us if he couldn't sell it for more money to other people in the village. That took like 10 minutes, and then he came back with one beautiful big kingfish that we could buy from him for a normal amount. It's about 20 euros for like 2.5 kilo fish. This is not a crazy amount. And then we had our beautiful friend A, who is an amazing cook, and who is together with Lex, a Dutch friend of mine, and he's living here in Koh Phangan. And she, together with my wife, prepared this fish. She made a steamed version, she made a baked version, she made a version with rum and some herbs, and she showed her cooking magic and turned this beautiful fresh fish into amazing food. Thank you, A, for doing this for us. Thank you for all the support you have been giving us here in Thailand during our visit, and making Jess's birthday yesterday even a more beautiful event. That was all for today, guys. I wish you an amazing day. Thank you for watching this video. Make sure you like it, give it a thumbs up, make sure you subscribe to our channel, make sure you hit the bell button so you will be notified on every new video. I wish you an amazing day, make the best of it again, and I see you guys tomorrow again. Bye.
I have to live with this.